welcome to First Link Training Centre again. This is going to be the second part of the three parts you've got to do when you do your Class 1 training. You've seen the reversing exercise video. We're now going to go through the coupling. So, the coupling and uncoupling process, okay? You've obviously moved the vehicle forward. The examiner will put you in a set position. It will then tell you to stop, switch off and come out and explain the coupling and uncoupling exercise to you, okay? He will then say, are you clear? You will say yes. He will say then, please show me, carry on. So, the vehicle has stopped. The first thing you do, if you'd like to follow me, is go around and apply the trailer brake. Now, it depends what type of vehicle you've got. On this particular vehicle, our trailer brake is on this side, on the near side of the vehicle. It's normally denominated by a red button. We pull the red button. B for brake. We're now going to wind down our legs, so when we take the traction unit forward, the trailer doesn't tip on its nose. L, legs. Wind it down. Down the legs down to the ground. I get my students to wind the panel so it's slightly, ever so slightly, just off the ground, about half an inch or so. The reason behind that is when you do your two tucks forward, the bottom section of the legs, if they're flat on the ground, may bend. If they do bend, they will not be able to go back in the column. Then we will have a problem. So just make sure they're slightly off the ground, about half an inch. Brake first, legs down. Now we'll go around to our airlines. Disconnect our airlines and our brakes. Open the side panel here. Hand on the handrail, one foot on the step, using the other handrail this side to take yourself safely up. I left you in this position, okay? In front of the bulkhead behind the traction unit. On this particular vehicle, we have electrics for insurance purposes. In your vehicles, they will be integrated. However, I'm going to take off the camera lens first. I'm going to store it here. I'm going to dispense with the cable so it's not in my way. Next, I'm going to start from top to bottom, right to left, taking off my Suzy's or electrics. Here we have the EBS. If you come down here, you'll see there's a little clip here. With that little clip there, we'll simply lift the lid, pull that, and it just oozes out. I'm going to make sure it's free from the other airlines. I'm going to store it away in this compartment designed for it, making sure I clip the ears on. That's secured. Then I come to the red electrical cable. Obviously, we've colour-coded ours, but as you can see, that is a female. The female can only go in the female slot, but I'm going to store it here because we've colour-coded it to make it nice and simple. And here we have the other one. As you can see, that one is a male. There's a little bit in the centre there. So that's the male. Okay, so when you put that together, you can check which is which. And we can put that, store that one there, because again, we have it colour coded. Then we come to our airlines, main airline. I'll show you on this one first. What we're going to do here is that's normally twisted away. We have a little nipple here. We have a U-joint, or you could call it a bridge. We're going to line them up. Okay, so I'm now going to do it on the main airline here. I'm going to line the pin up with the bridge. I'm going to grasp hold of the nut, not the cable, the nut, to steady this, because when I push that up, it's going to forcibly come off. I'm simply going to push the yellow, and there you go, it comes off. I'm going to store that away just there. The red airline is the opposite way around. Again, hold on to the nut, not the cable, the big nut, and pull the red section down onto the clip or the pin. Again, you can hear the forceful air come out. What I'm going to do is to securely put this away so when I move forward it doesn't drag along the floor. It's simply pull it down like that so it looks like this. I'm then going to couple up to this male coupling just here. I don't know if you can see that, but the male coupling just here. I'm going to pull it down, clip it on, relax my hand, it clips up, I'll double check it's on and simply twist it off so it can't fall off. That's my airlines all off. Brake, legs, airlines. I now climb down using the three points of contact and close the side panel door. I'm now walking round to do the remainder of the uncoupling. This brings us then to our fifth wheel. First and foremost, we have two handles on the fifth wheel. if you have two handles on your fifth wheel, please remember, it's always the handle that is closest to you and the higher of the two that opens up the fifth wheel. But prior to opening up the fifth wheel, I must ensure I take the clip off, otherwise the kingpin handle will not come out. So C for clip, take off. I've taken the clip off, I'm just gonna dangle it down like that. Now I'm gonna pull the kingpin handle out towards me and slide to right, making sure it rests on the lip just on the back end of the fifth wheel, this being the lip here. So out to my right, there's the square for the fifth wheel, and I sit it on that little wedge there. It's now disconnected. What I will do now is get in the track unit, pull it forward. The examiner says you can park it either side, it's your choice. You'll park it either, whichever side you decide on, making sure that the front of the track unit is level with the bulkhead of the trailer. If you're parking it on the near side, please ensure you leave sufficient room for yourself to open the door and get out the track unit. I'm now going to pull forward nice and slowly, checking that the rear axle does not jump up and smack the underneath of the trailer. So it's a nice slow movement. Once it's cleared, I will then park up next to the trailer. I'm now inside of the vehicle. What I'm gonna do is start the vehicle up, ensuring that my handbrake is on and it's in neutral. I'm now gonna select a full gear and move forward slowly. So, forward gear, blind spot check. I've now switched off the engine, obviously with the handbrake on, now to gear up, climb down. At this stage now, I'll turn around to the examiner and say I would now remove the number plate from the trailer. In other words, I'd retain it and put it in my cab because we may be doing a trailer change. The examiner will turn around to say, thank you very much. What I'd like you to do now, please, is show me how we would couple up this tractor unit and trailer safely. This being the trailer, he may say to you, you possibly may never have seen it before. So it's a brand new trailer. So that's what we're going to take it as. So first thing we'll do is walk round to the trailer and inspect the trailer prior to coupling up, if you'd like to follow me. Okay, for this part of the exercise, I've put my gloves on because I don't want my hands to get dirty and dirty up the steering wheel. Okay, because I'm now going to do a trailer check. So first thing on the trailer check is one. Very important, very, very important. Please check that, even though you've done it before, put your hand on the trailer brake, give it a little tug towards you. Don't just touch it, give it a little tug towards you. Two, you're now gonna check to make sure the handle is secure for the legs. It's not dangling about, it's nice and secured. Three, we're now gonna check that the kingpin is there. There's no point picking up a trailer if there's no kingpin, and it's in good order. We're now going to check the trailer. From this position here, I'm not moved too far away from the trailer brake. I can touch my underrun light, checking that it is clean, clear, damage-free, and secured. I'm now running my eyes, and I'm using my arms to illustrate to the examiner. I'm checking the body of the vehicle. In other words, there's no damage, and it's fit for purpose. As I start walking down the side of the trailer, I'm checking my underrun bars, giving them a little tap, and my lights to make sure everything's secure and fit for purpose. Yeah, the mud guard secured. Because I've got my gloves on, I'm going to show the examiner. I'm checking the tyre is in good condition. By putting my hand slightly on the inside of the tyre, I'm running them halfway round the tyre. If you're a big chap, you might be able to get all the way round. But halfway round the tyre, checking the tyre is in good nick. There's no bulges, no nails, good core ply. There's no core ply, and it's got good tread depth. We're checking the wheel nuts to make sure the wheel nuts are secured in good condition. We're checking our spray suppression unit is secured to the vehicle. And we do the same on this side of the vehicle. Mudguard, tyres, wheel nuts, spray suppression unit secure. Under run light. At this stage here, we now check our Voser plate, okay, or ministry plate, whatever you want to call it, to make sure that it is compatible with this vehicle. And I'm going to check the serial number here. I've touched it, I'm pointing at it. Okay, I'm touching it, not pointing at it. Moving down the vehicle then, light again, trailer level handle, make sure that's secure. And it brings it then down to the back of the vehicle. To demonstrate to the examiner what I'm checking, I'm going to point at the two lights, the two top marker lights, to say, yeah, I've checked them, they're clean, clear, damage free and secure. I'm checking that my cables are fit for purpose. I'm looking for any damage on the panels on my rolling door. I'm checking that the door is secured. It's not going to open when I'm driving along. I'm checking my reflectors are clean, clear, damage-free and secure. You don't have to say this. You just go through it. I'm just explaining why I'm doing it. I'm checking my rear cluster lights, yes. They're both in good condition. And I'm checking my number plate lights to make sure that's in good condition. Yeah, the number plate is there. Yes, I know. But on this particular exercise, on the examination, you would say to the examiner, I would take it off, but in effect, you would leave it on. And I'll tell you why a little bit later on. So we come down this side of the vehicle, and we check exactly the same this side of the vehicle. You can just watch me do this, because I explained it on the other side. This now brings me to the back of the vehicle or the bulkhead, okay? Again, I'm gonna start from the top, checking the top marker lights are in order, fit for purpose. I then come down, I'm checking my end out lights, I'm just pointing so you know exactly what I'm talking about, on each side by simply pointing them, and I'm gonna check that my electrics that I'm gonna be using, okay, are in good condition by giving them a quick check to make sure they're a-okay. If it's got a slide, just push it left and right to make sure or show that it's working. That is the trailer check. What you would do now is get back in the vehicle, move it forward, position it so it's going to come back onto the bulkhead of the trailer. Okay, once you've done that, what you'll do then, in fact, I'll go for that stage and I'll take it from there once I'm in position. I want it to, but prior to going under the trailer, I need to make some checks. Those checks are, I'm checking to make sure that the fifth wheel is going under the slide plate and not going over the slide plate, which may damage our electrics, which then would put our vehicle on VOR because we have electrics and no brakes. Two, I'm going to stand back and I'm going to check. I'm not going to go underneath the trailer. I'll just come back to the first on the run light. I'm going to squat slightly and I'm looking at my kingpin to see if it's in line with the V shape of the fifth wheel. If it's in line with the V shape of the fifth wheel, it'll go straight in. To confirm what I mean by that, I will demonstrate or show you. This middle section of the fifth wheel is the V shape. The kingpin will go slot straight in the middle. If we bang the sides either side of the fifth wheel, then we will have a problem. So we must keep the wing of the vehicle level with the trailer on each side. That tells us we're going back in a straight line. Okay? On this particular vehicle, because I like to hear three clicks, because the first click will be a warning for me to say that I'm going back under. So I'm going to rearm the kingpin handle. You'll see when I go back, you will hear click, 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 or clunk, clunk, clunk. I'll now demonstrate it. When you do this exercise, going backwards, please do it slowly. Slow as you possibly can. Like I said earlier, with those two movements forward, if my legs have been flat on the floor, there's a possibility I would have bent the bottom section of the legs. Hence, that's why they're half an inch off the floor. Now, as I've come out of the vehicle, I'm now going to recouple. Now it's the opposite way round. So I've done the two movements forward. I know that the kingpin is connected with the fifth wheel. It's secured. To stop the kingpin coming out, clip first. So kingpin has been secured. We're now going to put our clip on. I then go round, and I'm now going to connect my airlines. It's top to bottom. Now we're putting it back together. It's bottom, left to right to top. So the last one I took off was the secondary airline. So I'm going to put that on first. Hold it by the big nut. Pull the clip down. Put it on and just glide it up, and it pops straight on. Notice there, I've twisted the little bridge away from the little clip. I'm going to do exactly the same on this airline here. Hold it by the big nut, push up, twist off. Then I'm going to start with the yellow, making sure it's clear of any cables. Glide that in, it's on. Then the red. Glide that in, that's secured. EBS, electronic braking system. Bring that around the back, keeping it free. Open it up. With this, please make sure you put this in straight. Those holes in there have to match up with the pins inside the connection. If it's twisted, it's obviously not going to go in. So make sure you put that in straight. Slides in, clip the ears on. And then, with this particular vehicle, we're going to attach our camera again, reconnect our camera. That's the airlines done. Closing the side panel door once you've climbed down, we then move on to the legs. So, slap, catch. You can see the handle is towards your waist, okay? And secure it. The last thing we do then is push in the air brakes. So as you can see, if you go in order, what system we used there was called black. B for brake, L for legs, A for airlines, C for clip, K for kingpin. And when we put it back together again, we've done it in reverse order. If you can remember black, you shouldn't really have a problem, so long as you realise or understand what each letter means. The examiner now come over to you and you say to the examiner, I'm now going to check the lights on this trailer. Can you assist me checking my brakes, my brake lights? They will say yes. I'll take my gloves off, I'll go to the vehicle, climb in, ignition on, put all my lights on, and then check the lights. I'm going to do that now. Okay, so I'm going to start on the near side to check the lights. Remember, we're checking the lights on the trailer, not the tractor unit. So I'll come to the bulkhead of the trailer. I know it's quite sunny, but that LED light at the top there is on. As you can see, the end out light down here is also on. All we're going to do is get this part done because there's a set period of time, so they say. Just the trailer lights. So, on the run lights, yes, they're all good, they're all working. I'll come to the rear of the vehicle. Yeah, my top marker lights are working. My rear cluster lights are working. My number plate light is working. When your number plate light is on, that is when you would say to the examiner, I will now put my number plate on. Now you see why I didn't take it off. Okay? Number plate light is on. You will say to the examiner, I now put my number plate on. He's happy with that. You then come down this side to check your lights. Top marker light, bottom marker light. I'm now going to shout to my colleague. Can you help me check my brake lights, please? I will then climb in the vehicle, close the door, put my foot on the brake. When I get the thumbs up, then I know the brakes are working. Good. I'll now switch the lights off, including the hazard lights. Right, out of the vehicle. That is how you do the coupling and uncoupling exercise. At the end of the exercise, once the examiner gets in, they'll get in, put their coats on, make themselves comfortable. They may ask you a question, and that question will probably be, what's the last thing you check before you leave? You'll simply say air brakes. You don't have to demonstrate, just say air brakes. Then you're complete and you're ready now to go on the road, and they'll describe to you what you'll be doing next. Thank you very much. Yeah.